of April 2017, a historic moment for Sarawak, a Sarawak state government-owned development bank, has been approved by Bank Negara Malaysia. Bank Negara Malaysia has approved the setting up of a Sarawak state government-owned development bank known as the Development Bank of Sarawak, or DBOS, D-B-O-S. The state government of Sarawak will operate DBOS with full financial support from the state government and will function as a development bank only. To further reflect its mandate as an approved development financial institution, DFI, bracket, DBOS do not undertake or advertise for public deposit as provided under Section 137 and 138 of the Act. The bank will be operated on a financial model that will help fund the state strategic projects in line with the state effort to promote socio-economic transformation catch-up plan 2017 to 2030. The BOS are to foster economic growth in Sarawak and to contribute towards the acceleration process of economic development of the state. In the process, the state will ensure a successful and prudent operation of the BOS. It is the BOS' main objective to ensure that the revenue generated from the financing activities of the state strategic projects will prosper the state economy and therefore the rakyat. With further consistent and sustainable revenue generated, the state will be able to further support both the state economic development transformation agenda. The state strategic projects include four key development sectors, namely, number one, ICT infrastructure, that is the digital economy we have been talking about. Number two, energy sector, which include power generation, oil and gas. Number three, urban public transportation. This one include LRT. And service sector. Service sector meaning include healthcare and also tourism. The BOS main objectives are as follow. Number one, mobilization of investment of private and public capital for productive purposes. Number two, financing state strategic development projects which contribute most to the harmonious economic growth of the state as a whole, with special emphasis on high impact projects. Number three, coordination of plans and policies of the state with a view to achieving better utilization of the state resources, making them economically more complementary and expanding Sarawak foreign trade. Number four, provision of technical assistance to the state government for the preparation, financing, and execution of development projects. And five, undertaking of such other activities which may help to achieve its main objective. So that is the function as well as the objective of our bank called Development Bank of Sarawak. And I must express my appreciation to the Prime Minister, also the Federal Government and Bank Negara, for giving their approval to for us to establish our own development bank. And this is what I've been talking about, our own financial model. Meaning we have our own financial model to accelerate our catch-up plan in order Sarawak can be developed further. It is a financial institution that will give loans on strategic project only that have that have high impact on our development. Macam ICT infrastructure tu, we can finance it. And for us in Sarawak, we have our own bank that will definitely give capital. Tadi orang talking about capital. For them, but a commercial feasibility studies must be done that will give also return to the bank, but at the same time you create new industrial activity, economic activities in the market. It's just like any commercial bank. That's why I said we would like to express our thanks to Prime Minister, because I got two major assets that will transform our economy and within our control. Number one is Bakun. Number two is this bank.
The boss.
And then the boss, of course, will help to build that infrastructure that we are talking about, the ICT infrastructure. Including RIT, urban public transport, urban. This is a special project.